welcome back to my channel. I'm Patty, and this is my handmade lifestyle. In today's video, I'm going to make a amazing, yummy, delicious, old-fashioned hot fudge sauce. It's going to be incredible, so don't go anywhere. I know you're going to want to see how to do this recipe. If you are a returning viewer, I would just like to say hello. And thank you so much for tuning back in. And if you are a new viewer, I would like to welcome you to the channel. And I would like to invite you to subscribe to the channel today and make sure you hit the notification bell so that you always know when new videos go up, which are mostly twice a week, but sometimes three times a week. And they're always good. And I know you're going to want to see all of them because they're amazing! In today's video, I'm going to be cooking out of one of my very favorite cookbooks. It's from my top five favorite food writers, cookbook writers, bloggers, the whole thing. I just think he's amazing. It is my dream to meet him one day. And this is the book. It's called The Perfect Scoop. It's by David Leibovitz. There's a really nice picture of him in here. Here he is. He's so cool. If you don't know about David, he's very well known. He's very highly respected. He's been food blogging for like 20 years. So I think he started actually when it was still done on Notepad. So he's been around, he knows what he's doing. And he's written several books. This is the first book that I have purchased from him. I have since purchased a couple of other things, but this is my first book. And this is the book that taught me how to make ice cream. And we're going to make some of his recipes out of this book as the summer goes on, because I think ice cream in summer is perfect. What I like so much about David is that he's not just shotgunning recipes at you. He gives you a really fun story. He gives you some context. And you know, a lot of people, I'm just gonna like say this, a lot of people out there are complaining big time that food writers or food bloggers have the nerve to include a little personal story with their recipe. And they just wanna jump to the recipe and be done with it. And you know, people put a lot of time and effort into writing this stuff, and I'm sorry, I personally, I like to read the story. I think that's what makes it real. To me, that's what gets you excited about making something new, is the story behind it. But anyway, he writes really good story. He also is a very good teacher, and this book will tell you all the ins and outs of making ice cream. So definitely recommend. But not only is it ice cream, it's things like sauces. So hot fudge sauce, sorbets, granitas, the whole thing. And today we're going to make his hot fudge sauce. And I think that's what it's called. I'll just tell you, let's find it. And I'm going to make this particular recipe exactly as he has it written. Yes, it's called classic hot fudge sauce. And it's on page 164 of his book. You can find this book used on Amazon if you want to go that route. I buy a lot of books that way. It is nice if you buy it from him directly on his website, because then you're supporting, you know, him as an artist and a writer. And he works really hard and he does really good stuff. So if you're gonna buy it from David. I'm super proud of this book because this is a first edition hardback and I still have the original cover. So when the day comes, and someday it will come, I will get to meet him and I'm gonna bring this book for him to sign. Okay, without further ado, let's make the sauce. There's a French term in cooking that's called, and I'm probably gonna butcher this, but it's called mise en place. And what it means is everything in its place. So what that means is when you're gonna cook, get all your stuff ready. Okay, don't be measuring your flour while you're creaming your butter and eggs, or your butter and sugar. Don't do that. Get it all ready before. And then as you're doing the cooking and mixing process, it's ready to go. You're not going to then make a mistake in a measurement. And when you're doing this kind of cooking, precision is important. You want to have it right. So I have already measured everything out, so we're going to take a look at it, and it's all measured. So, okay, let's look at it. I will give you the written recipe below, and I will link to David's website. I'm sure he's got this on his website as well. So yeah, I'm not taking anything from David. I'm just making one of his recipes and showing you how well written it is and how easily it's going to come together. Okay, so here's what I've done. In the Pyrex here, I've got my heavy cream and my light corn syrup. So they're all measured out in here. In this bowl, I have the cocoa and the brown sugar. And then over here, I have the chocolate and the butter. Ideally, you would want to have the really good chocolate that you chop up. But chocolate chips are not ideal for this, but guess what? It's all I had. It's probably what you have in your pantry. So that's what we're gonna go with. It'll be fine. It's still gonna be good. It'll work. We're just gonna make it work. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that this is well combined, and then we're gonna put the liquid and this mixture into the saucepan. We're going to bring it up to a boil. We're not gonna do that by going like right to high on the burner. You don't wanna do that. We're going to start at a medium, like so maybe around 6. We're not gonna take it all the way up to high. You don't ever wanna do that. Unless you're searing, but you know, this is not that kind of cooking. So I'm gonna put it on 6. Bring it up to a boil, stir it, and then we're going to just put in the chocolate and butter and let it melt. It's almost like a ganache. So first thing I'm going to do is to use my immersion blender and get this better combined before it goes into the pot. And then we'll just mix everything in. So I'm going to do that now. Oh, and I do want to make, a comment before we start. This recipe calls for Dutched cocoa, and that is a specific thing. And so I'm using just regular Hershey's cocoa, the special dark. Honestly, this was rated by America's Test Kitchen as like the best cocoa for cooking. So, you know, don't diss the Hershey's in the grocery store. This is actually rated as being very good. And if you read carefully, you'll see that it says Dutched cocoa in the fine print. And that's what you want. So you have Dutched and non-Dutched, and it has something to do with the acid balance in the chocolate. And depending on whether you have Dutched or non-Dutched, it makes a difference. That's all I know right now. I'll have to investigate it more closely and see exactly what the difference is. But for now, Dutched cocoa. And you know, the next time you're in the store, go into the baking section and just look at the cocos and just, you know, read the labels. I find it interesting. I will walk down the baking aisle and just look at all the stuff and read about it. I'm nerdy like that. To me, that's a really fun afternoon. Okay, let's get going. Okay, so I'm going to do the immersion blender first. This thing, oh my God, I love this thing. You just put it down. And that's it. I don't want to make whipped cream, so I'm going to stop. Yeah, so it doesn't look like much. It's just the powder on top of the cream. So I've got the heat going. What I'm going to do is just stand here and whisk it, and we'll get it combined and bring it up to the boil, and 30 seconds of that. And then we'll add our chocolate and butter. Also, at the end of the process, when we add the butter and chocolate, we're going to add a little vanilla. So we add that at the end. That's just one more step, which is no big deal, right? So I'm just whisking. I like these silicone whisks. They're super nice to use. They clean up well. They don't transfer any heat, which is nice. Okay, and now it looks like the most beautiful hot chocolate you've ever seen. I have to say, I was kind of surprised when I said, all right, I'm going to make this recipe, and then I really read the recipe and started getting the ingredients out. I was like, holy Toledo, this is a lot of chocolate. So it's very chocolatey. So if you're not a lover of chocolate, this is not going to be a video for you. However, why would you be watching, first of all? But if you love chocolate, you're going to love this recipe. I will also add, this is not a dietetic recipe. If you're on one of these keto and paleo diets or whatever they are, and you build in what they call a cheat day where you're allowed to have a normal life, this would be great for them. However, it looks like it's going to make quite a lot. So if you don't have willpower, I don't know, you may have to keep the leftovers at the neighbor's house or something, because I don't think you're going to be able to tolerate pulling out those leftover meal prepped things at the end of the week when you've got this chocolate sauce sitting there. And for me, that would be entirely too much temptation. But I'm also not going to eat leftovers after 5 days, so. But that's just me. So something to watch for when you're doing a sauce like this is when you start to see that steam rising from the surface, that's your indicator that you're coming up to temperature. Anytime you're working with a dairy product on the heat, you want to be really, really careful about how you cook that. So you don't want to go too hot. You want to make sure that you're constantly moving the mixture around. You want to monitor for when that steam starts coming up. All of that is very important when you have dairy on heat, because you don't want to burn it, you know, you don't want to singe it. That would be sad. This is already just about ready to go. So this is very fast to make. Just in the time that we've been talking, it's almost ready. And as I said, it's not on high. It's like on 6. So, you know, don't crank your stove up to 11, especially when you're dealing with desserts. Really any cooking. If you're doing Chinese cooking, like I have done some Chinese videos here. I like Trader Joe's stuff, and I've made some of their things. You're going to need a little bit of high heat for that. But not with this. This would be like a medium heat, I would call it. Medium high. And I'm going to turn it down to medium just to be on the safe side. And it's bubbling. It's a slow bubble. I want you to see this, so hold on. Okay, that's the boil. So, 30 seconds. We're basically done. Okay. All right, and now we're going to add our chocolate and butter. And I measured everything out on my food scale using grams, because David includes grams. We're gonna treat this like a ganache and just let the chocolate and the butter sit in the hot dairy a couple of minutes, let it just melt, because chocolate melts really easily. You do not need to crank heat up to melt chocolate. The best description for cooking chocolate and how to monitor temperature that I have ever heard came from Mary Berry, of course, on Bake Off. And she said, when you're working with chocolate, keep in mind that chocolate will melt in a child's pocket. And so, you know, it's not 500 degrees in a child's pocket. It's maybe 100 degrees. So it doesn't take a lot of heat to melt your chocolate. So never crank your heat way up when you're trying to melt anything chocolatey. You don't have to. This is all melting and I'm just gonna whisk it in. Then he calls for about a teaspoon of vanilla. I've been getting my vanilla at Trader Joe. It's like the best price that I can find for it because, you know, goodness knows, it's expensive right now. Oh, this is so beautiful. Oh my goodness. So, with this being a classic fudge sauce, what you'll want to do is when you are ready to serve it, you do want it to be warm. So you'll have to refrigerate it when you're not using it. If you can refrain from just, you know, eating it by the spoonful. Gosh, like a chocolate soup almost. You'll have to refrigerate it. So you probably want to just microwave it gently and then put it over top of your ice cream. And I am going to put this on top of my vanilla ice cream, which I will link to that video. And I can't wait. Okay, let me show you how this looks. Well, that's all well and good, but how is this stuff really going to taste on ice cream? I can tell you, it's really, really good. I mean, how are you going to get wrong with this? Let's be real. Just putting it right on top of the ice cream. To be frank with you, it's super hot here today, and even though we're inside, it's still hard to keep the ice cream from melting, and then you put hot fudge on it, and it really wants to melt, but it's absolutely delicious. And this ice cream is the ice cream that I made in my vanilla ice cream video, which I will link to for you. So yeah, it's good. I definitely recommend that you make the hot fudge sauce. I used mostly dark chocolate products, so it's not really a sweet, but I think that balance is nice with the vanilla ice cream. If you want something sweeter for your chocolate sauce, I would do milk chocolate type of products, but I like the bitter of a dark chocolate, so that's what I went with. You know what, that's it. That's our video for this week. I'm gonna go ahead and enjoy this before it completely melts into a soup. And I'll see you in the next video. Make sure that you make some of this summer and let me know how it is. Until then, I'll see you around.